the core Sidemen members is me and Toby went to school together, and then you have JJ and Simon who went to school together. Me and JJ were friends through YouTube. Funnily enough, I was googling KSI at one point.
Word kind of got round that he was posting videos, but no one could really believe it because at school he was, you know, this very quiet, shy, reserved guy. And then you go on YouTube, he's there going like, oh my god, blah, blah, blah. It was just surreal to see.
Grade 5, motherfucker!
I met Simon through school, and year 7 we hated each other. We would always be fighting. And then for some reason in year 8 onwards we just were cool. We just forgot about everything and we were just blessed.
Ethan comes into that story. This must be like 2012. And on my birthday, I was watching Twitch streams and he was streaming FIFA and was enjoying it. Could tell that, oh, he's like a London lad. It's good vibes, it's good fun, and he's a funny character. I got on with him well very quickly. There's a lot of like common interests we had. But at the time, I was in another Skype call with the other boys and we were chatting about it. And then Vic was chatting to me about it personally, like via text. So I was like, oh, Vic's coming to call.
It's bizarre when you think you can pinpoint individual sentences that changed the course of the next 10 years of all of our lives.
Harry joined the Sidemen because he was blowing up crazily. He was a superstar before the Sidemen. He was the young FIFA guy that made his own come up.
Oh my fucking... What the fuck? Oh, I am done! Oh shit! Oh, that's properly fucked!
My unique selling point was that I was really bad at the game, but I enjoyed the whole video making process.
He came and he stuck, and he's like sort of forever been under the wing. At the end of the day, we were just friends. People ended up connecting with us because of our connection on the screens. It's quite cute, really.